But it is good to get outside your comfort range. And we had, was that that Jade Buddha, was that just 2 years ago, a year and a half ago, remember? When they had the Vietnamese temple? About a year and a half ago, there was this traveling exhibit of this huge Jade Buddha that originated, the jade came from Canada. A wealthy Canadian couple bought it, had it transported to Thailand to be carved in Carlson of the Soto Zen Dharma Ryan Zen Center, myself, Jacqueline Endell, who teaches both Vipassana, coming out of the Theravada tradition, and she studied with the Theravada monks, and also Tibetan Buddhism. Hansen, who is a Tibetan Buddhist, formerly a Zen Buddhist. And we go to this huge Vietnamese-American temple over in southeast here. We didn't even know it was there. And it was quite charming in that the only people who spoke English were the Vietnamese-American kids who were like 12, 14 years old. And I was rather charmed that the whole group of us had to sit there for 2 hours and not have any idea what's going on. And just when it was time to stand up, one of the handful of Vietnamese who spoke English said to us, it's time to stand up, we'll stand up. It's good for us. It's good for senior teachers in the tradition to get outside our comfort level and to realize that there's whole realms where we don't even have the language to take it in. And North America continues to be a place where different traditions come into contact with one another in a complexity and a detail that they've never really interacted in Asia. They never have any reason to. They never were in the same country at the same time, in the same part of the country. And we have a lot to learn from one another, and have something of great value. But there's none of them that I am dismissive regarding.